Welcome on this tutorial, wish all you are well. In previous tutorial, I have discussed about architecture of PLC. There, I have discussed fixed type PLC, modular type PLC, and distributed type PLC. Now, here in this tutorial, I will discuss what are the different modules normally there in modular type or distributed type of PLC. Entering into the discussion, please subscribe. It will encourage me to upload more and more important tutorials. Different branded PLC use different types of modules, but I will discuss here the general modules which are normally used in different PLCs. The modules are power supply, CPU, interface module, signal modules, function modules, and communication processor or communication modules. These are the modules which are generally used in modular PLC and distributed PLC. All the modules are placed on a rack. For some model of PLC, the position of these modules are fixed, but higher version of PLCs, the placement of these different modules are not fixed. There, any module can be placed in any position. Say for the case of Siemens S7300, in slot number 1, the power supply should be always there. In slot number 2, there will be CPU. The slot number 3 is fixed or reserved for interface module. Now this interface module might be there or might not be there, but this 3 number slot is always reserved for interface module. The slot number starting from 4, there might be placed signal modules, function modules, or communication processor, or any other modules. This is for Siemens S7300. But for example, say Siemens S7400, any module can be placed at any position, means at any slots, means at any slot of the chassis or rack. Now I will describe about few points on these different modules. These are examples of different modules: power supply module, central processing unit, CPU, communication module, signal module, function modules, interface module. All these modules are placed on the chassis or rack. Rack is the component that holds everything together. Everything means all the modules along with the necessary electronic circuitry. Rack has cabinets for placing these modules. At the starting of PLC use, we must configure hardwares. So at the starting of hardware configuration, this rack is normally configured at first. In Siemens PLC, it comes in two sizes, 9 slots and 18 slots. This rack or chassis provides interconnectivity between different modules. There are mainly two types of racks. One is called passive backplane, another one is active backplane. For passive backplane, it has only slots and very little or no additional circuitry. Whereas in active backplane, this contains slots as well as necessary circuitry to control communications between the slots. As an example, the S7300 have passive backplane type chassis, and in S7400 model, it is having active backplane type of chassis or rack. Next, power supply module. Power supply module provides required level of regulated power supply to the different modules in the rack via system backplane bus. So it provides the required level of power supply for different modules. Power supply module do not provide load voltage for the signal module. In general, 220 volt AC UPS power supply is given to the power supply module of the PLC. This power supply module ultimately generates 5 or 24 volt DC, which is normally required for the case of different modules. In some model, battery is also installed for backup of RAM, which has program memory for CPU. These are few examples of power supply module. Say, power supply module from Schneider Electric, power supply module from Allen Bradley, from Siemens, from Mitsubishi Electric. Next coming CPU module. The brain of the whole PLC is the CPU module. This module typically lives in the slot beside the power supply. And this is for older PLCs. Nowadays, anywhere any module can be placed. The CPU of the PLC has different types of operating modes. For example, in Siemens PLC, the operating modes are programming mode, stop mode, and run mode. In programming mode, PLC accepts the downloaded logic from programmer or PC. Program editing can be done in programming mode and stop mode. While we need to run the PLC, the CPU is placed in run mode so that it can execute the program and operate the process. Memory reset mode is used to reset the memory of the CPU. These are few examples of CPU module. CPU module from Mitsubishi Melsec, CPU module from Keyence, CPU module from Siemens. See here, in Siemens CPU, these are the different modes. This is memory reset. This is used for resetting memory. Stop mode to stop the CPU or PLC. This is run mode and run program mode. In run mode, program execution, read-only access possible from programmer. Run and run P, both mode is used for execution of the program. But for run mode from the programmer, the program can be read only. But in the case of run P mode from the programmer, we can read as well as write the program. Here different status are there. First one is SF. This is used to indicate any type of error. This might be group error, might be any type of internal CPU fault or any type of fault occurred at different modules. This is or battery fault, when battery is empty or there is no existence of battery or any type of fault in battery, that is indicated by this status. This DC 5 volt status, this is force. This indicates that at least one input or output is forced. This run gives the status while CPU is in running condition, and this is stop. It indicates CPU is in stop mode. Next, signal module. Signal modules provides an interface for the field inputs and outputs to the programmable controller. Means signal modules are directly connected with the field devices and it sends signal from the field devices to the PLC. Input signal modules are used for connecting digital or analog field inputs to PLC. Output signal modules are used for connecting digital or analog field outputs from PLC to output devices. These are examples of signal module. Signal module consists of input module and output module. Input-output module might be discrete, might be analog. This is the example of discrete input module from Allen Bradley model SLC500 PLC. Here we can see 8 number of input can be connected with this module. And these are the different connecting position. This is an example of discrete output modules from Coyo model DL06. From here we can see Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y5 like this, around 16 numbers of digital outputs or digital output devices can be connected with this module. This is example of analog input output module. As this is analog input output, some A2D converter or D2A converter must be there with this type of module. Because PLC only understand 0 or 1 and the inputs and output signals are analog signal. So no doubt for the case of input module, A2D converter should be there, and for the case of output module, D2A converter should be there. Example of analog signals are 0 to 10 volt, 0 to 5 volt, current 0 to 20 milliampere, 4 to 20 milliampere, output from thermocouple, RTD, strain gauge, etc. In this figure, see here, 4 numbers of analog inputs might be connected. 0, 1 terminal, 3, 4 terminal, 6, 7 terminal, 9, 10 terminal. 4 numbers of analog inputs might be connected with this analog input module. Similarly here, we can see 4 number of output devices might be connected with this analog output module. Different PLC's signal module consists of input, output, both. Say, this is example of Siemens S7-1200 PLC. In a single module, here 16 digital input channels are there as well as 16 digital output channels are there. So, this is the combined digital I/O module. Similarly, for the case of analog I/O module, this is having 4 analog input channels as well as 2 analog output channels. So, this is a particular input-output combined module. Now coming to interface module. This module is optional, means it might be there in a particular model or might not be there. This interface module is used for rack-to-rack communication in multi-tier configuration. See here, this is rack number 1 and this is rack number 2. If a single rack is not sufficient, means more number of input-output modules or other modules might be required, then another rack is required to be used. This is normally termed as multi-tier configuration. In this case, to communicate with first rack to the second rack, the interface module is used. See, this is the interface module for first rack. This is interface module for second rack. There is a communication way or communication cable to communicate with these two racks. Connection of remote input output is achieved by installing an interface module. Say this is remote I/O modules, means these modules are placed somewhere else in the field, not in the control room. So in that case also, interface module is used to communicate main PLC modules with remote input output modules. For Siemens S7-300, interface module is normally placed in slot number 3. But for higher version, say Siemens S7-400, in any slot, any module is permitted. Next, coming to communication processor or communication module. This module is optional, means if required, then only this module are used. These modules can be used for providing additional communication port, means if any additional communication ports are required to communicate with different racks or different I/O system, means different remote I/O system, then this communication processor or this communication modules are used. It is used for the networking communication between multiple processor for PLC. Also, communication processor exchanges data between PLC, SCADA, human machine interface and other systems. This communication module provides different networking facility like point-to-point communications, Profibus communications, industrial Ethernet communications, etc. Next, coming to function module, and also it is called special purpose module. Signal other than digital or analog are connected to function module. Example, high speed counter module. This is used to generate or used to count high frequency signal. Another example might be PID module, which is used for process control system, OING module, etc. So, this type of modules are special purpose module, or these are used for any type of special functions Those are normally cannot be achieved by using normal digital or analog PLC modules. Up to this discussion, we learned about different modules used in PLCs. The general modules which are normally used are power supply module, central processing unit, interface module, different signal modules, communication processor or modules, function modules, etc. In older PLC, these modules were placed at a particular slot on the rack. But nowadays, there are different models of different brands can be placed or permitted to be placed at any slot of the rack. In next tutorial, I will discuss how different discrete inputs and outputs can be connected with different input-output modules. Be with me, subscribe, put comments and queries in comment section.